Hello friends, this question is from test series 1. This is a 1 mark question in the chapters of network solution methodology. In the question we have a network which contains a 10 volt battery along with a resistive networks of 3 resistors, 2 ohm, 1 ohm and 2 ohm. In a branch of 1 ohm resistor we have a current source of 2 ampere. In the problem we need to calculate the voltage across this current source. We need to calculate the voltage across this current source Vx. So, in the beginning, let's name this node as a V. So, let's name this node as a V. Now, we need to find out the voltage across this current source. So, it's better that we can apply the nodal across this node. Because with the help of nodal, we can find out the voltage across this whole arm, which we have named as V. So apply the nodal at node B. Apply nodal at V. So it will be V. So I'm assuming that all the three currents from node V are moving out. Each and every branch will have a current. So right now I'm assuming that all the three branches are moving, all the three branch currents are moving out. In the nodal, what we do, we actually apply the KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, at a particular node. So at the time of the applying the Kirchhoff's KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, we have this freedom that we can assume the direction of current. But once you have assumed the direction of current, after that you need to apply the KCL according to that only. So it doesn't really matter whether you assume the current outside the node or inside the node. But whatever you have assumed, you need to apply the KCL accordingly. So right here, I have assumed that all the three currents are moving out. Now I am applying the KCL accordingly. If the current is moving out from the node, we know that the current is always flow from higher potential to low potential. So I am assuming that my node V is positive. So I am applying nodal as V minus 10. Upon 2, because KCL says that the sum of the incoming currents is equal to the sum of outgoing current. There is no incoming current, all the three currents are moving out, so all the three currents will be sum V minus 3, V minus 10 upon 2, V minus 0 upon 2 branch current of this resistor N plus 2, because in this branch, in a 2 ampere branch, we already know that key. The branch of this 1 ohm resistor is 2 ampere. Branch current of this 1 ohm resistor is 2 ampere. Because there is already a current source is attached in the branch. In the series, current is same. So we know that in this branch, 2 ampere current is flowing. So my equation will be V minus 10 by 2 plus V by 2 plus 2 is equal to 0. So if we simplify this equation, it will be 2V minus equal to 6. Or V is equal to 3 volt. By simplification, we can calculate the value of V as 3 volt. So, voltage across this 3 volt. So, voltage of V, the V is a node voltage or a branch voltage. The total branch voltage is 3 volt. We know that in this branch, 2 volt, 2 ampere current is flowing. So, what will be the voltage drop across this 1 ohm resistor? We know that the voltage is current into resistor. We know that the current of this branch is 2 ampere, resistor is 1 ohm. So the voltage drop across this 1 ohm resistor will be 1 into 2 is 2 volt, and overall voltage drop of the branch is 3 volt. Now we can apply the KVL here as overall voltage drop of the branch is 3 volt, which is equal to the voltage drop across 1 ampere 1 ohm resistor plus voltage drop across the current source. So let's see that in this branch we have one ohm resistor and one current source. Across 1 ohm resistor the current is 2 ampere, so voltage drop must be 2 volt, 2 into 1, and overall voltage drop will be equal to the voltage of node V, which we have calculated as 3 volt. So now if you can apply the KVL at this branch, 3 is equal to 2 into 1, plus Vx, so my Vx will be 1 volt. So if 3 volt voltage drop is across the entire branch has a voltage drop of 3 volt, across the 1 ohm resistor we have a voltage drop of 1 volt, so there will be, across the 1 ohm resistor we have a voltage drop of 2 volt, so across the current source we have a voltage drop of 1 volt. So my current option is option D. My D will be my current option. Thank you.